Welcome, this is a demonstration of controlling Nixie tubes with a Raspberry Pi using the I2C protocol. Nixie tubes are these old glass tubes. These ones are of Russian manufacture. They're operated by high voltage, and you can typically display numbers on them, and some of them have symbols. Here we have a total of four IN12 tubes. Over here is high voltage power supply. This thing is set up right now to produce about 160-170 volts. Runs over here via this wire to power the tubes. Each tube has a 12K resistor on it. And also has a, on these driver boards, is a K155 driver chip. I've got one driver chip for each tube. So to control it via I2C, we have an MCP23017 I.O. expander. This is a lot nicer I.O. expander than the PCF8574. First of all, it's 16 bits, and secondly, it has a number of additional features such as adjustable pull-ups, latching capability, etc. In this case, we've got it simply configured to just function the pins as outputs. The pins are connected in groups of four to each one of the driver chips. So first we've got these four red wires go to the first driver, four orange wires to the second driver, four yellows to the third, four greens to the fourth. We also have these drivers powered by 5 volt and ground via these purple wires. And I'm powering the I.O. expander via 3.3 volts via this yellow wire from the Pi. These three pins over here in the I.O. expander control address, so each I.O. expander can have any of 8 different addresses. Here we've tied them all to low, so its address ends up at 20 hex. The 20 part is fixed as part of the chip, and then we add 0 to that for our 3 pins that are all low. So one of the nice things about I2C, it's a protocol. There's a driver built into the Pi to do it. It only requires 2 wires for IOs, which are these green and blue ones here. One of them is a clock, the other is a data pin. The data pin's bi-directional. Okay, just to show off the demo program that I wrote, it has a few modes built into it. One of them is counting. There's a fixed display, cycling all of the digits, moving digits back and forth, and a clock, which will tell you that it's currently 2055 universal time. So that's really all there is to this. This is basically an evolution of my original project, which was controlling these with a shift register, switching to controlling them via I2C. Hope you enjoyed.